Hello, welcome to Ekidel, where we train future civil and structural engineers. My name is Fashe Ochet. Today, as you can see this structure, we want to see how we can model cantilever slab of different curve. How we can model curved cantilever slab. So that's what we want to look at. We discover that many a times the architect might give you some want to look like complex cantilever slab. Then how do you do it? How do you model it and design it in Protastructure? So that is why we are here for you in Ekidel, to tell you that with you as a structural engineer, after God, all things are possible. So now looking at this slab, this 1, 2, 3, this 3 curve, we want to use it as an example to train you on how to model curved cantilever slab. So with this, any slab, any curve that you want, I believe you should be able to do it. As you can see this one, as you can see this structure, as you can see this slab, as you can see, we want to see how we can model something of this nature. You can see this one too, you can see. So we want to see how we can model this structure. So therefore, follow me as we see how this can be modeled. This is what we call curved cantilever slab, different type. So we are going to do it. So let's move on to see how it can be modeled. All right, welcome back. So let's see how we can do this. So once you have your architectural drawing, the next thing to do is to know the dimensions, and not only that, also know the how it's been, you know, more designed, how it's been drawn from, you know, maybe AutoCAD or all of those things, and get to know the dimensions. So now let's see, from what we have seen the other time, let's now see how it can be modeled from this side. Now what you need to do, what you now do, is to come to this place called concrete members. Once you are here, come down to this place called slab/column/edge and in bracket line/act. So come and click on this one. Based on the first one we want to do, you click on what? On slab/column/edge/arc. This one is what we are going to click on. So do like click on this one and come to this place from the center. Don't forget, from the center, click here, and also come and click the end of the slab and click. Then bring it out and press your F2, then minus, because it's coming down, that's why we are putting minus. If it's above like this, then we can put plus, but it's coming down, that's why we put minus. So therefore, from your architectural drawing, what's the distance at the center to the, what's the distance from the center of this beam to this place? Let's assume it's let's say 1000, let's assume 1000, good. Then click, press what? Enter and wait for it. So you can see it now. So wait for it, this is it. So the next thing to do is to go back again to this same place and click on it, on this particular slab/column/edge/line/arc, then come to this place now, slab/column/edge/line/arc, and click. So now come to this place where you started from, here, zoom it here to this, from here to here, to this particular place, click, and then right click your, from your cursor, from your mouse rather, right click, and then click on what? Finish. So once you have done that, wait for it. So now it's done. So the next thing to do is to bring your slab property and insert. What I say, slab property and insert. Come to this place and click on what? Slab. So once you have clicked on slab, since you are modeling and everything, so you can come here and click. So you can see it now. So this is how you do this one. So we are done with this. So now click outside and see. So you are done. So you can see your slab now. So now let's go for the 3D and see how it looks like. Our 3D. So you can see it. As simple as that. So you can see our slab. Our curved cantilever slab, so you can see. So therefore, let's go further and do the next the second to the last one, which is from here to here. How that one has been done, now let's see how we can do it. So come to the same place, cantilever, and click on this one, and also come to this place and click on this one. So therefore, what you need to do is to click from the center again. Now from your architectural drawing, what's the center, what's the distance of this place, what's the distance of this edge? Let's assume it's a, let's say it's a 700. Press your F2 first. F2 and enter what? 700. So now press what? Enter. So you can now see. You can see. That means from this place are what? 700. Make sure it's straight and do what? And click. So you can see it now. So now from your architectural drawing, what's the length from this place to this side? So let's assume, press your F2. Then what's this? And let's assume it's let's say 500, or let's just say 400. 400. Press enter. Then make sure it's straight. It's straight, good, it's straight. So you can now see it from here. So what do you need to do? What? Press escape. Oh no, do not escape. Right click and click on what? Finish. Do you see it now? So the same thing, we go back there and also pick the same thing you have picked and come to this place again and do the same thing from here to here. You say it's what? I think we said 1,000, right? If I'm right. Now press your F2 first. F2, 1,000, press enter. Then you can see how we can see from here to this place is what? 1,000. Is it 1,000 or 700? No, I think it's 700. Let me undo. Let's say F2, 700. Then enter. So you can see our 700. Make sure it's straight. Make sure it's straight. It's okay. So then come to this direction. This direction again and press F2. And we'll say this one is what? 400. Press what? Enter. So I make sure it's straight. Make sure it's straight. Make sure it's straight. Good. So you can see now. Now right click and click on what? Finish. So you can see it now. So they are set. So the next thing to do now is come to this place and also on this place. But this time around, we are not picking this one. Is this one that we need? You can see it now. Slab search column edge distance. Click on it and then come to this place. Click and also click the last one here. Make sure it's intercepting. Yes, good. Now you can see the curve. You can see it. You can see it. Now from this place outward, what is the curve? Let's assume because this one is 700, let's say it's 300, so that we make from this place to this place at the center is maybe 1,000. Let's make it 300. So now say F2, what? Press your minus what? 300. Now click on what? Enter. So you can see it. You can see it. You can see the curve. You can see how it is. Or let me undo it. Let's make it better. Let me undo it. So go back and click on it. Click on this curve. Then come here, click, and also here, click. Then I'll make it more. Curve. Then let me say that's F2 minus, let's say 500. I just assume 500. Depends on architectural drawing. Don't forget. So press enter and let's see. So better, isn't it? So now the next thing we are going to do now, I've done this, I press enter, then you come back to do because you have to connect them. It's very important you connect. So click on this one and then come here and to this place. Connect it. Then right click and click on what? Finish. So having done this one like this, the next thing to do is to go and take your slab, click on slab. Then if it's the same parameters and all of that, so come to this place and click. So you can see now close this one, close this out. And let's see. So you can see it now. So you can see how we have created this curve now. So the next thing we are going to do, the next one, the last one that we did the other time. So let's see how that one can be also be modeled. As you are watching this channel, in case you have not subscribed to this channel, I would advise you to do so that you can have access to our videos. It's very, very important. And at the same time, if you like this video, I want to click on like button down there. Click on like button. At the same time, give it a thumbs up. At the same time, I want to say that we are going to produce what we call Protast setting. It's very important. Protast, there are some settings you need to do that will help you in when it comes to your final, you know, arrangement of your drawing for printing. So there are things you need to do from Protastructure that will really help you by the time you export them to AutoCAD or Stonebridge detailing software, which I will advise you to also get. So but in part one, we have done part one of Protast setting. Then part two, we are going to be looking at also beam setting. There are something you need to do that will help you, that when you get to your AutoCAD, you can easily arrange your beam, and before you know it, you don't waste your time on that. So let's see how we can quickly model this one we are talking about. So the same thing, looking at what we have done the other time, so let's see how we can quickly do that. On this, click on, sorry, on this, this one, and click on this. So we now take our dimension. Let's see from the center of this, then what is the distance? Let's make it let's 500, sorry, F2, don't forget F2, 500, enter. So you can see this is my 500. I click, then bring it to this place. F2 again. Let's say F2. Where's my F2? Yes. Then 500 again. I'll just make it even because of the video. Then, but don't forget to follow your architectural drawing, the dimension on your architectural drawing. So come to this place again. F2, 500, enter. So let me make it straight. Good. So I'll do what? Right click and what? Finish. I believe you can see it, right? So now go back to the same place and also pick the same thing, come to this place, click, and also come to this place from the center, then F2, 500, enter, make sure it's straight, and come to this place also, F2, 500, enter, make sure it's also straight, make sure you get it straight, good, and also come to this place, F2 500. All right, okay, enter. So let's see, make sure it's straight. It's not. Make sure it's straight. Okay, so now right click and do what? Finish. So you can see, so the next thing to do is to now come and do what, and take your curve. So you now click on this one, then from here, from this place to what, to this place. I'm coming, let's intercept. Good. So now I'll now come to this place. Since from here to this place 500 and now 500, basically this one is just, I'm just assuming my figure, but don't forget to use your architectural dimension. So therefore I put what, let's say 400. I put my 400 and then enter, right click, and also what, say okay, enter. Thank you. Sorry, it was not this one that we did that time, so let me remove it. It was a straight line that we used. So I'll come back here to this place and click on this. Okay, then once I've clicked on it, then I come back to this place again. Come here. After clicking on it, come here to this place and click. Good. Then what do? I right click and click on what? Finish, yes. Then I'll go back again and pick my arc. This one, click, and then come to this place. And then come to this particular place now. Sorry, it's coming up. Come to this particular place now and then click and come, just to make sure that yes, it's connected, and click on this one. Good. Then once that one is done, I also do what? Right click and then click on finish. So it is done. So now what we are going to do now is to now insert our slab. So what do? I come back to this place. I come here. Come up. I come here, I click on my what? Slab. So I'll click on my slab. So let's wait for it to come up. Sorry, the system. Alright, this is the same parameter that we still have. In case your parameter changes, so you have to change it based on you. So now what do? I click here so you can see. Then what do? I close this one, click outside. So let's now see what we have produced so far by going to our 3D and see. So you can see all model. So this is how to mold your curved cantilever slab. You can see everything done perfectly, just as we have said. You can see this is how to do it. And loaded also, maybe might be the another part whereby we'll see how it can be loaded also. Maybe let me use the other one as example, like this one, just like what we have already watched. Let's go back and see. All right, this place, at this point, what do? You go back to your concrete member, and once you click on your concrete member, what do? You click on what? Slab load. On your slab load, click on what? On your line load. So this is my line load. Then you must have calculated your load. So once you have calculated, it has been calculated. Let's say it's 9.89. So you can see. Then what do? I come to this place and then draw my line load on this. So once that one is done, I click on what? On close. I click on close. Yes, once that one is done, then let's now go back and see if you are able to do it. So you can see. Likewise, it can be done on all of this. All of this can be done. And in case, as I said, and in case you don't know how to load your slab without using line load, you know, we are going to produce a video also that will talk about how to load your slab without using what? Line load for your walls. That automatically it takes care of the slab, takes care of your wall. So without using line load. So that video very soon will also come up. So that's why I said it's very important that you subscribe to our Ekidel channel, so that whatever video we have, so we are launching or we are sending online, so that you can also have what? Notification at the same time, like the video. So that's very important. Thank you so much. Not to forget, in Ekidel we have Ekidel mentorship class where we train specially. There are some things that we might not be able to see here, reason because we are only concentrated on why we are producing the video or we are teaching you. But in Ekidel mentorship class, we give you everything. Time is not what is not an obstacle. So we tell you everything that we know, everything that we have, we give onto you. So I would advise you to join Ekidel mentorship class. Not only that, we also have Ekidel Ekidel group, whereby we have other engineers that, you know, join the group, that whenever there's a question, anybody that's having a challenge, write the challenge, and before you know it, many engineers attend to you and that problem is being solved. And while doing that, in case you also have a particular challenge, you can post it, and I trust you, I trust them, it shall also be solved. And if there's any question asked, I also have idea, you can also do what? Respond. So Ekidel is a place where we are trying to see that when it comes to a better place to be in terms of engineering, yes, we can actually achieve it. That's why Ekidel is a place where I would advise you to be, and also invite your friends who are also looking for where they can upgrade, where they can learn more than being what they have gotten in school. So therefore, thank you so much. Till I see you next time, the same station, which is Ekidel channel. Thank you and God bless you. Sorry, before I forget, now this is a Prota 2018, and when it comes to Prota 2020, it's still the same thing. It's still the same procedure, the same everything. The only thing you need to do is to go to your, what we call a model. Under that model, once you click on it, you will see all the tools we have used here. You will see them, just the same thing we use it, that's how you're going to use there. So there's no cause for alarm that this is 2018, how can I do it 2022? It's the same thing. When you get 2022, when you have is one we're using, just click on model. Under that model, you will see everything there. Is that okay? You will see everything. Bye for now.